Hello everyone, I am Dr. Karan Patel, Senior Consultant Orthopedician from TX Hospital. Today I will discuss about the post-COVID complications in orthopedics. So as we all know, COVID-19 infection, it's a very deadly infection and it has a lot of problems in our human body. As we all know, the common symptoms like dry cough, fever, sore throat and all those things the patient is experiencing. From the orthopedic point of view, patient experiences myalgias, joint pains like that is polyarthralgia, fatigue, tiredness, and more recently we have now seeing a lot of patients with avascular necrosis of hip. Is a very common complication which we are seeing nowadays because of long term steroid use in post COVID patients. This usually happens, this condition is actually because of interrupted blood supply to a part of bone, to a small piece of bone in the femoral head, so which causes necrosis of the piece of bone and which causes pain and limping in the patient, which we are seeing very commonly nowadays in our OPD. So basically avascular necrosis of bone, it is divided into four stages, stage 1, 2, 3 and 4. So it starts with first stage, stage 1 and 2. Usually the femoral head is not destroyed, so then at least we can start with non-operative treatment and like rest, analgesics, anti-inflammatories, bisphosphonates, then lifestyle modifications. So these treatment modalities we can use, and surgical options available for us in stage 1 and 2 are core decompression alone or core decompression along with BMAC or the PRP therapy. So what we do in core decompression is we just drill the dead piece of bone with maybe a 3.2 drill bit or whichever drill bit we are used to. So then we decompress the bone, we decompress the dead piece of bone, and then we fill it, either we leave it if it is a small piece of bone, or if there is a large piece of bone, if there is a big void, then we fill it with a bone graft or with a PRP or with a BMAC nowadays, which is in stage 3 and 4 when the femoral head is destroyed and when the arthritic changes start appearing, then we have no other option than to go with a total hip replacement. So patients eventually in stage 1 and 2, it is better we diagnose them earlier, and because one third of the cases they improve, one third of the cases they stay the same, and one third of the cases they go on to the next stage. So at least we can say one third of the cases we can improve them. So it's better to diagnose it in the earlier stages. So see a doctor, consult an orthopedician if you have pain and limping few weeks or few months after you have suffered from COVID infection. Thank you.